Hello and Namaste. Today I am going to tell you about anaphylaxis in adults, emergency department management. I am Dr. Pramin Prasad Gupta, Associate Professor, Department of General Practice and Emergency Medicine, BP Kerala Institute of Health Science. Anaphylaxis is very, very common and we have to know how we are going to treat it. And anaphylaxis is an acute, potentially life-threatening multi-system syndrome caused by the sudden release of mast cell mediators into the systemic circulation. It most often results from immunoglobulin E-mediated reactions to food, drugs, and insect stings. But any agent capable of inciting a sudden systemic degranulation of mast cell can induce it. So how we are going to diagnose anaphylaxis? So diagnosis of anaphylaxis is always clinical. So we have to assess signs and symptoms of anaphylaxis. The detailed description of the acute episode, including antecedent activities and events occurring within the preceding minutes to hours. There are diagnostic criteria which we can use to diagnose anaphylaxis. There are three diagnostic criteria and each of it reflects a different clinical presentation. Highly likely when any one of the following three criteria is fulfilled. So the three criteria, among the first one is acute onset of an illness, minutes to several hours, with involvement of the skin, mucosal tissue or both. Example, general hives, pruritus or flushing, swollen lips, tongue and uvula. And at least one of the following, respiratory compromise, as for example, dyspnea, wheeze, bronchospasm, stridor or hypoxemia. And reduced blood pressure or associated symptoms of in-organ dysfunction, that is hypotonia, collapse, syncope and incontinence. The second criteria, if two or more of the following that occur rapidly after exposure to a likely allergen for that patient. If involvement of the skin mucosal tissues, example general hives, itch, floss, swollen lips, tongues and uvula. Respiratory compromise, example dyspnea, wheeze, bronchospasm, stridor, hypoxemia. Reduced blood pressure or associated symptoms, example hypotonia, collapse, syncope or incontinence. Persistent gastrointestinal symptoms, example cramping, abdominal pain and vomiting. Whereas the third criteria, if reduced blood pressure after exposure to a known allergen for that patient. If infants and children, low systolic pressure or greater than 30% decrease in systolic pressure. In adults, systolic blood pressure of less than 90 mm of mercury or greater than 30% decrease from that person's baseline. These are low systolic pressure for children and this has been taken from research. The criteria 3 is intended to detect anaphylactic episode in which only one organ system is involved and is applied to patients who have been exposed to substance to which they are known to be allergic. There will be patients who do not fulfill any of those criteria but for whom the administration of adrenaline is appropriate. As for example, if a patient known history of allergen to peanuts come in an emergency with history of bronchospasm, angioedema, severe urticaria, we have to treat that person with adrenaline. Let's come on signs and symptoms. So signs and symptoms varies from system to system. So starting with the skin, and skin consists of 90% of symptoms. Feeling of warmth, flushing, itching, urticaria, angioedema and hair standing on end, that is pilot erection. Oral, itching or tingling of lips, tongue or palate, edema of lips, tongue, uvula, metallic taste, respiratory compromise of 85%, So nose, there will be itching, congestion, rhinorrhea and sneezing. Laryngeal, there will be itching and tightness in the throat, dysphonia, hoarseness and stridor. And lower airways, there will be shortness of breath, that's dyspnea. Chest tightness, cough, wheezing and sinuses. Whereas gastro and cardio comprise of 45% of each. In gastro, there will be nausea, abdominal pain, vomiting, diarrhea and dysphagia, that there will be difficulty in swallowing. In cardiovascular, there will be feeling of faintness or dizziness, syncope, altered mental status, chest pain, palpitation, tachycardia, bradycardia or other dysarrhythmia, hypotension, tunnel vision, difficulty in hearing, urinary or fecal incontinence and cardiac arrest. Whereas there may be neurological symptoms like anxiety, apprehension, sense of impending doom, seizure, headache and confusion. Young children may have sudden behavioral changes. There will be ocular symptoms also, and that could be periorbital itching, erythema and edema, tearing and conjunctival erythema. And in other, there will be uterine cramps in women and girls. Death from anaphylaxis usually results from asphyxiation due to upper or lower airway obstruction or from cardiovascular collapse. Death from anaphylaxis can occur within minutes. That's why we have to treat promptly anaphylaxis. There might be some diagnostic pitfalls, and that are reluctant to diagnose anaphylaxis in the absence of hypotension or shock. Like some physicians are still reluctant. Even though changes in blood pressure are not required for the diagnosis according to criteria 1 or 2. Skin symptoms and signs which are helpful in making diagnosis are absent or unrecognized in up to 10% of all episodes. And anaphylaxis in a patient with asthma may be mistaken for an asthma exacerbation if accompanying skin symptoms and signs are overlooked. Let's talk about something on anaphylaxis pathology, pathophysiology, and we will be concise in this. So anaphylaxis and anaphylactic reaction. Anaphylaxis is always IgE mediated, whereas anaphylactic is non-IgE mediated. The anaphylaxis reactions, these are two types. One is immunological anaphylaxis, in which there is IgE mediated reaction, IgG mediated reactions, and immune complex complement mediated reactions. IgG mediated reactions haven't been identified in human yet. And then there will be non-immunological anaphylaxis. So what happened? When any allergens, we come across any allergen, then they attack the blood cells, mast cells and basophils in blood. So what happened? The antigen attacks B cells, there will be IgE antibody formation. IgE binds to the surface of mast cell, basophils with Fc receptors, calcium influx into mast cells or basophils. There will be release of chemical mediators, and that will affect to the lungs, heart and skin, and then the signs and symptoms of anaphylaxis will appear. So these are very concise pathophysiology, whereas the mediator, that is histamine, and due to which there will be pruritus, edema, wheezing, diarrhea and hypotension. Leukotrienes that cause bronchoconstriction, so wheezing will be there. Platelet activating factor that also causes bronchoconstriction and vasodilation. C3A and C5A that cause smooth muscle contraction and vasodilation. And tryptase, which action is proteolysis, and it causes edema and smooth muscle contraction. Now there are some comorbidities and differential diagnosis of anaphylaxis. The comorbidities and concurrent medication that might impact the severity and treatment of anaphylaxis, and those are asthma, other pulmonary diseases like COPD, interstitial lung disease, cardiovascular disease like ischemic heart disease, hypertensive vascular disease or cardiomyopathy, mast cell disorder, that's systemic mastocytosis or mast cell activating syndrome, and currently administered medication, if it is there, that will be beta-adrenergic blocker, alpha-adrenergic blockers, angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors, angiotensin 2 receptor blockers, tricyclic antidepressants, monoamine oxidase inhibitors, and attention deficit hyperactivity disorder medications like stimulants such as methylphenidate and amphetamines, and recreational use of cocaine. The differential diagnosis of anaphylaxis: there are common disorders which are acute generalized urticaria or angioedema, acute asthma exacerbation, vasovagal syncope, panic attack or acute anxiety attack. Other respiratory events like pulmonary embolism, pneumothorax, foreign body aspiration, vocal cord dysfunction, epiglottitis, and hyperventilation. There will be cardiac events like myocardial infarction, dysarrhythmia, acute symptoms related to structural disorders like aortic stenosis, hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, shock, hypovolemic, gastrointestinal bleed, ruptured ectopic pregnancy, ruptured aortic aneurysm, systemic capillary leak syndrome. It will be cardiogenic shock, distributive shock, or obstructive shock. If flushing, and it could be due to perimenopause, carcinoid syndrome, autonomic epilepsy, or medications, alcohol, or medullary carcinoma of thyroid, or red man syndrome. Postprandial syndromes like scombroidosis, anisakiasis, pollen food allergy syndrome, food poisoning, and caustic ingestion. Neurologic events like seizure and cardiovascular event, and non-organic disease like Munchausen syndrome and psychosomatic episode. The differential diagnoses of anaphylaxis are unique and it has to be evaluated very closely. But prompt assessment of anaphylaxis is very, very necessary, because early treatment is always indicated in management of anaphylaxis. So there is no role of laboratory investigation, but then also there are some laboratory investigation that we can do, but it must not be available in all the periphery setting, even in the most of the tertiary care setting also. So anaphylaxis is always a clinical diagnosis. Do not await laboratory confirmation. Clinical diagnosis can sometimes be retrospectively supported by documentation of elevated concentrations of serum or plasma total tryptase, and normal is 1 to 11.4 nanogram per milliliter. Plasma histamine peak within 5 to 15 minutes of onset of symptoms and then decline to baseline by 60 minutes. And there are new trials going on, and that is on mature beta tryptase level. Now let's focus on treatment of anaphylaxis. So we have to evaluate the danger signs. If there is rapid progression of symptoms, respiratory distress like stridor, wheezing, dyspnea, increased walk-up breathing, persistent cough, cyanosis, if vomiting is there, if patient complains of abdominal pain, hypotension, if dysarrhythmia is there, chest pain and collapse. So those danger signs have to be evaluated very closely. And the main and foremost treatment of anaphylaxis is adrenaline. So emergency treatment, we can do prompt assessment and treatment, and that are very critical and it is very, very necessary. The immediate management, what we can do is removal of the inciting cause if possible. As for example, if stings or bee stings are there, we have to take it out, stop infusion of suspected medication, call for help, placement of the patient in the supine position with the lower extremities elevated, and intramuscular injection of adrenaline followed by additional adrenaline IM or IV. Supplemental high flow oxygen, 15 liters per minute using non-breather mask, volume resuscitation with IV fluids. And there are initial assessment and management, and their attention should be focused on airway, breathing and circulation, as well as alternate. Lips, tongue and oral pharynx are assessed for angioedema, whereas patient is asked to speak and we can assess periglottic or glottic swelling. Common airway management. Intervention should be performed immediately if marked stridor or respiratory arrest is present. Preparation for early intervention should be made if there is any airway involvement or significant edema of tongue or pharyngeal tissues, including uvula, or if voice alteration has occurred. In minority of cases, emergency cricothyrectomy may be required if upper airway edema prevents access to glottic. Intravenous fluid, which is very, very necessary. Massive fluid shifts can occur rapidly due to increased vascular permeability, with transfer of up to 35% of intravascular volume into the extravascular space within minutes. Fluid resuscitation should be initiated immediately in patients who present with orthostasis, hypotension, or incomplete response to initial IM adrenaline. 1 to 2 liters of normal saline at the most rapid flow rate in first minutes of treatment. We have to give bolus fluid. Large volume of fluid may require, and that is up to 7 liters. We can use lactate ringer if large volume needed. Some clinicians prefer it because large volume of normal saline causes hyperchloremic metabolic acidosis. Now, the most and foremost treatment is adrenaline, and it is an immediate treatment of anaphylaxis. It has to be given immediately. The dilution of IM injection contains 1 mg per ml, and ampules may be labeled at 1 is to 1000, whereas for IV, we have to make that 1 is to 1000 to 1 is to 10,000. 0.01 mg per kg, maximum of 0.5 mg injected IM or IV. If IM is given, it has to be given in a mid outer thigh. Dose may be repeated at 5 to 15 minutes of interval if there is no response or an inadequate response. For anaphylaxis, the dose is 1/10 or less of the IV adrenaline dose that is used in cardiac arrest. Slow IV infusion is given if patient with profound hypotension or sign suggestive of impending shock is presented, and the dose is 1 microgram per ml. Start infusion at 0.1 microgram per kg per minute and increase it every 2 to 3 minutes by 0.05 microgram per kg per minute. So these are the various doses of adrenaline, like in adult 0.5 ml, in child more than 12 years 0.5 ml, child 6 to 12 years it is 0.3 ml, child less than 6 years it is 0.15 ml. The other drug like chlorpheniramine and hydrocortisone, the doses of it, and IV fluid challenge. The beneficial effects and adverse effects of epinephrine in the treatment of anaphylaxis. The beneficial effects are: at alpha 1 receptor, it increased vasoconstriction at low doses, increased peripheral vascular resistance, increased blood pressure, decreased mucosal edema. At beta 1 receptor, it increased heart rate and increased force of cardiac contraction. Whereas at beta 2 receptor, it decreased mediator release from mast cell and basophils, increased bronchodilation, and increased vasodilation. And the common adverse effects are like anxiety, palpitation, pallor, tremor, fear, restlessness, dizziness, and headache. And uncommon ventricular arrhythmia, angina, myocardial infarction, pulmonary edema. But there is no contraindication of adrenaline if we are going to use it in anaphylaxis. So there are other adjunctive agents like S1 antihistamines and S2 antihistamines. S1 antihistamines like cetirizine 10 mg. And diphenhydramine 25 to 50 mg, and those are used in emergency department with adrenaline. Antihistamine, it doesn't relieve upper or lower airway obstruction or shock, so it's rarely used, and if used, it has to be given with like famotidine 20 mg. Bronchodilator, for the treatment of bronchospasm not responsive to adrenaline, an inhaled salbutamol by mouthpiece or nebulizer can be used. Use of glucocorticoids. There are various research. In some research, it shows there is no beneficial effect of glucocorticoids, whereas in some research shows there is no harm of using glucocorticoids. That's why we can use glucocorticoids in some cases. Like glucocorticoids are commonly given in the treatment of anaphylaxis, although there is little evidence of clear benefit. Approach is not to administer glucocorticoids routinely to patients who respond well to adrenaline, except patient with severe symptoms requiring hospitalization or with history of asthma. Methylprednisolone can be given 1 to 2 mg per kg per day for 1 to 2 days, and hydrocortisone can be given 200 mg stat. Now the patient has to be observed, and while we have to be careful while discharging that patient. Patient with moderate anaphylaxis who do not respond promptly to adrenaline, and all patients with severe anaphylaxis should be admitted. In emergency, if patient responds to adrenaline, then we can observe that patient for at least 4 hours from the last dose of adrenaline. And while we plan for discharge, patient has to be given clear instruction to return if symptoms reappears. We have to give advice to follow up to the allergist if possible to find out the allergens, and we have to tell them what to do if signs and symptoms of anaphylaxis occurs. So these are the algorithm in management of anaphylaxis in emergency department, like signs and symptoms of airway obstruction, bronchospasm, hypotension, immediate action, what we are going to do. Like for airway obstruction, we can nebulize with 5 mg, prepare for difficult airway including early surgical airway, bronchospasm where continuous salbutamol nebulization or hydrocortisone, hypotension, IV fluid. So if there is inadequate response or immediate life trend or deterioration, so the adrenaline, and if hypotension, then IV fluid can be given. If severe bradycardia, then atropine or metronidazole and glucagon can be given. If there is anaphylactic cardiac arrest, we have to follow advanced life support protocol and immediate adrenaline, rapid escalation to high dose adrenaline, and ensure high volume IV fluid resuscitation as above. So take home message is, anaphylaxis is life threatening conditions, early recognition and prompt treatment is essential. And the first and most important treatment in anaphylaxis is adrenaline. There is no absolute contraindication to adrenaline in the setting of anaphylaxis. Time counts to save the patient on the impending doom of anaphylactic shock. So we have to be careful. We have to treat promptly anaphylaxis for saving life of patients. Thank you, and thank you for your kind attention.